Hello Edtech fans, welcome to a new video in which we'll be showing you the easy process of installation of a Moodle platform locally in your personal computer. Now you may be wondering, if Moodle is a web-based application that works with an internet connection, then what is the point of installing a Moodle site in a computer? Well, the main reasons might be, for example, that you want to be able to create your own Moodle courses without the need of an internet connection, because you don't have one available, for example, so that you can use the resources already present in your computer in order to create your courses and later upload these courses to a production, to a connected Moodle site. Or maybe because you want to experiment with Moodle as an administrator or as a teacher without risking the courses already working in your production Moodle site. For example, because you want to install and try out different Moodle plugins to see how they work. And I'm sure that you can think of other reasons that require the installation of Moodle in your computer. Now, the process of installation is easy, and we'll find everything we need in the main site of the Moodle community, that is moodle.org. Once in the page, the first step is to go to the download section. Here, we click on the latest Moodle version, in this case 3.9.1, and then click on the link for the Moodle installer package, choosing the one that goes with your operating system. In my case, it is Windows. Then we look for the appropriate version of Moodle that we want to install. In most cases, the best option will be the one marked as the latest stable release. We click on the download zip button for that version and choose the destination folder for this zip file, which includes everything you need to run Moodle on your computer. There are various elements in this package: the Moodle software itself to run the site, a server software called Apache, which acts as the local server without the need for an external server on the internet. We also have PHP, the program language in which Moodle has been coded, and finally a program called MySQL, which is a database program that will store and deal with all the tables of data that Moodle needs to handle. Everything is there in the installer file that we've just downloaded. Now, when the download process is finished, we click on the file and then unzip its contents to the location that we choose in our Explorer. You'll find a README text with some technical information for this package, and also two .exe files that you'll use later in order to start and stop your Moodle server. Later on, we can put links to these two .exes on a handy place, for example, the desktop window. When the unzipping is finished, we go to the destination folder. In my case, I previously created a Moodle folder in the root of my C drive. Here, we'll find the two .exe files to start and stop the server and the database. Like we said, I recommend adding direct links to these two start-stop .exes on the desktop, so that you can find them easily in the future. We click on Start Moodle, and the program will start the Apache server. A security alert will pop up, and we need to allow access to go on with the process. Once finished, we minimize this black system window and go to our browser, in my case Chrome. Here we write localhost and press intro. The Moodle installer program will start. Of course, this process of installation is only needed the first time you use Moodle on your computer. In the future, all you need to do is click Start Moodle before going to the localhost in the browser, and then click on Stop Moodle when you finish using the platform, so that the server and the database processes are shut. Here, you can choose the language for the installation, or if you're happy with English, then click Next. In the next screen, you will be asked to confirm the paths where the different directories will be installed. Unless there is a good reason to change them, the best option is to accept the default values and click Next to go to the database settings. Again, in most cases, the default names will be OK. Introduce the database password. If you intend to manipulate the database later, you should remember this password for future access. Otherwise, it's not important. Click Next and you'll be presented with a copyright notice. Click Continue to accept the copyright conditions. And in the next page, Moodle checks that the server meets all the requirements. There should be no problem here. It will warn you that you don't have HTTPS for extra security. You don't need it, so click Continue. Now the program will create the hundreds of tables that Moodle requires in order to record all the data. This process will take a few minutes, so sit back and relax. Once done, click Continue to go to the final steps. We are near the end. First, you will set up the admin user for your platform. Here, be careful not to forget the password for this user, or you won't be able to access your own site in the future. Fill up the required fields for the admin and click on Update Profile. Then, if you like, give a full and short name for your site. This is not important, since you can change them later on. The rest of the settings are not important, but you can go through them and change them if you like. Save changes and voila! Your new local Moodle site is already installed in your computer, ready to be used, and you are logged in as the admin user with all the superpowers that this gives you. Now you can go to the site administration and start creating courses, or changing the site configuration, or installing new plugins, or just playing around with your brand new Moodle site. I hope you enjoy. If you want to be notified of new videos like this, please subscribe to my channel, click the notification bell, and share these videos with your colleagues. Thank you for watching, and see you soon!